In this video, we're going to take a closer look at PiCloud Connect publications. Publications are an easy way for you to share portions of your company's data and infrastructure with the people who need it most. To give you a better idea of what I'm talking about, let's open up the Pi System Explorer and take a look at my ice cream company. As you can see, my ice cream company has three different sites, and each site is broken down into the different aspects of ice cream production. Publications allow me to share pieces of this data with corporate headquarters, with my ingredient supplier, or even the manufacturers who keep an eye on my machinery. So for instance, one of the most important pieces of ice cream production is my chiller. I can share this performance data with the manufacturer who will monitor it automatically for me. At the same time, I can share my remaining quantity of chocolate chips with my supplier so that they automatically refill me before I run out. One of the great things about publications is that if I wanted to, I can instead share this level and share all of my information about all of my ingredients with my supplier. With a traditional non-cloud-based solution, I would have to set up and create these points individually, but with PiCloud Connect, I'm automatically sending not just these data streams, but also the infrastructure that's already in my AF database. So for this video, I'm going to create a publication that shares all of my ingredient data with my supplier. Before I go and create that publication, I want to double check the name of the database that I have this information stored in. As you can see, the database is named after my company, the Nisqually Creamery Company. Now we can head to the PiCloud Connect portal and create that publication. As you can see here, there's a prefix to the PiCloud Services hyperlink that corresponds to my company. This prefix is defined when you first sign up for PiCloud Connect. For more information on this, please see our other YouTube videos. Now I'm going to hit the PiCloud Connect tile, and this brings me to the PiCloud Connect portal page. Before we begin creating a publication, it's always a good idea to check to make sure that your PiCloud Connect node is working correctly. For that, we'll go to the system tile. The PiCloud Connect node I'm using for this demonstration is sitting in my Rivendell site, and I can see here that the node is showing a good status. Now we can navigate to the publications section, either using the original tile back on the main page or using this publications tab on the left. On this tab, we can see all of our current publications, including any publications that we have been invited to subscribe to ourselves. Keep in mind that PiCloud Connect operates under a multi-tenant environment. This means that your company can be a publisher, a subscriber, or both at the same time. Now let's go ahead and create that new publication. To start off, we'll want to select the database that our data is stored in. Please note that the naming convention is AF server name followed by database name. This is important to pay attention to if you happen to be connected to multiple AF servers. We'll select our company database and hit next. Here we can see the same element structure that we saw in System Explorer. Since I want to share all of my ingredient data, I will select the ingredients level. Anytime you select one of these elements, it automatically shares all of the sub-elements below it. A quick side note while we're on this page. Right now, we are choosing to share AF elements. This means that we are not only sharing the element hierarchy, we're also sharing the time series data and attributes associated with these different points. Another option that publications provide is to instead share templates. When you select this option, you're automatically sharing all of the templates associated with the database that you selected on the previous screen. What's this useful for? Well, let's say that we were opening up a fourth site to make more ice cream. Rather than building that whole AF database manually, I can instead pick a database I'm already using at one of my existing sites and share the template instead. This will automatically import all the templates that I've created and allow them to get set up much faster. For the purpose of this demonstration, however, we're going to stick to sharing elements. Now we get to set the start time of our publication. This is a fixed point in time from which we want to start sharing our data. At any point when someone subscribes to our publication, They will download all the data from that time up to present time and then start updating accordingly. The offset option that we have here will be defined when we actually push start and begin publishing that publication. Now we have to name our publication. Since you may be dealing with multiple publications and subscriptions at the same time, we encourage you to use descriptive names for your publications. The See Existing Publications hyperlink will take us back to the Publications page. Here we can see that our new publication has been created, but is in the stop state. Before we start it, let's go ahead and invite a subscriber. Subscribers are invited via email address, so I'm going to go ahead and invite Mike, my supplier. Now that Mike has been added as a subscriber, he will receive an email informing him that he's been invited. For more information on that, please see our subscription video. Now that we have a subscriber lined up, we can start publishing. We can either click Start Publishing here, or head back out to the main publications page and hit Start Publishing. And there we go. Now we've created our publication. So to wrap up, publications are an easy way to share sections of your company's infrastructure and data with the people who need it most. Publications can be tailor-made to specific subscribers to share as much or as little data as you'd like. Since data is sent through the cloud, you can share this information with multiple people without having to jump through the traditional security and networking hurdles that you would get with a one-to-one connection like our Pi2Pi interfaces. Thank you for watching, and please don't forget to check out the other videos in our Pi Cloud Connect series.